Dear viewers, peace and blessings be upon you, and welcome in the ninth episode of the program Rituals, the program that comes broadcasted on ECRA under the super sponsorship of the Ministry of Islamic Guidance of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, which broadcasts more than 1,000 episodes to raise awareness and educate those who want to pursue pilgrimage of this year. We have our guest Khalid bin Abdullah al-Mislih, and we spoke about different topics and important topics pertaining Hajj, pilgrimage. Today we're going to talk about the virtue of the 10 days and their judgments, and I'd like to greet the brothers and sisters, and I'd like to bless myself and you, congratulate myself and you and the whole Islamic nation for the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. This night is the first night of the first day of the last of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. We're talking about the virtues and judgments concerning those days. Your Eminence would like to tell our viewers that they can be able to watch this episode in English and Arabic, the English language, through the main channel of ECRA, and the second, the French language, they can be able to watch it through the international channel. And after you congratulate you and congratulate the viewers, what are the virtue of the 10 days, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah? Those were Allah had sworn in His words by the dawn and the nights of the 10 days, and swearing God in those 10 days, it shows the greatness of those 10 days. From another aspect, Allah had made them a known days. And those 10 days are the known 10 days, as Ibn Abbas have said in Turjum al-Quran and Hadr al-Ummah. And when he said they are known in time and in their virtue and the holiness and their status, which we can understand from Allah's words in describing those days, by describing them by known days. Those are the most loved days to Allah Almighty, because this is where the believers, they get closer to Allah Almighty. And as the Prophet Muhammad said in this hadith, there is no other pleasant days to Allah more than those days, which those 10 days. What about striving and struggle in the cause of Allah? And those better than those, and also there's a hadith by Abdullah ibn Umar, and those days are preferable and greater than others. And also Prophet Muhammad said that, and there is no other action is better and preferable by Allah more than those who are conducted during those 10 days. And there's a lot of hadiths which are, and none of them mentioned during those hadiths that those are better than the others when it comes to actions. But those during those days, this is where the Muslim gets closer to Allah. Also, we mentioned that fasting all of days, it equals a whole year, and praying at night, all those days doesn't have any base, but the virtue of those days, but the only virtue that they are the greatest days of for Allah Almighty, and this is where the one a Muslim can be closer and get closer to Allah Almighty. All what Allah chose, as Allah said, He chooses, and He is the only creator of the time and the place, and He will choose what he wants as far as days, in terms of days, and the situation, and the status, and the persons, and he makes them, those are the best time of all times. If someone asks, if Allah make them the greatest, what are the best actions to get closer to Allah? And the most preferable or the most pleasant actions actually are performing obligations and the obligatories, and also concerning the pillars of worship, like performing prayers and giving alms, and the obligatory fasting, and performing pilgrimage, and also the other rights, like being good to your parents and the family and to the neighborhood, the neighbors, and give charity, and one of others good deeds, which are varies and too many. One of whatever it's obligatory, it's those obligations that makes you closer to Allah. When you mention those, the greatness of those days, a lot of people would think that the reward and the advantage only in the supererogatories of worships, or but multiplying rewards, not only in supererogatory, but to start with in the obligations. That's why Omar, may God bless with him, if you missed any obligations, you may recompensate it or recover it during those days. That's why if you need to recover any missed obligations, you can be able to perform it during those days. And for example, if you want to fast, you have to fast during these days. And this holy hadith, there is nothing closer to me that my slave can be able to do only, but is to perform the obligatories. This is where one get rewarded. This is the first thing where a worshiper gets closer to Allah. So firstly is performing obligatories in all the Sharia's aspect. The second thing, one of the portals or the gates where people get closer to Allah during those days, the supererogatories. And this is an open and wide gate. And Allah had opened all the gates and open all the doors, the door of good deeds. There is no one certain door, but prayer is a door, and giving alms is a door, and pilgrimage is a door, giving charity is a door, and giving rights, and all of those doors are doors for one to get closer to Allah. It doesn't specify one. The best actions for Allah, or greater to Allah, are during those days. And this contains all the good deeds which Allah had and His Prophet ordered us to perform, the hidden ones and the unhidden ones. For example, like prayers and going to mosque and reciting Quran, giving charity, and being generous to the family and parents, and being treat the spouse nicely, and all these actions come under the good deeds term. There is nothing there's no better actions to be conducted more greater than conducting them during those days. This is the best time where one worshiper get closer to Allah. And there's other narration. There are no other days in which the actions are greater, but those during this times. And the greatest doors of conducting good deeds, it's remembrance, the remembrance in all its forms. The mentioning and feeling and by hearts, that's why. And mentioning the name of Allah in known days for what livelihood he's been bestowed upon him. He stipulated the goodness of this action. The second, what came in Abdullah ibn Umar's hadith by Ahmad and else, and also came by Tabarani and Ibn Abbas, that Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, there are no greater days to Allah in which an action should be taken more than those actions during those days. So you have to increase exalting Allah Almighty and praising Allah Almighty in our stayings and walking and sittings. We're not restricted during those days, from the start of these days until the last days of the days of Tashrik, the 13th day. All of those are the remembrance days. This is where one can mention and remember Allah Almighty in all times and with his all senses. When mentioning exalted be to Allah, exalted be Allah, there is no God but Allah Almighty, and thank be to Allah. We will come back to this in detail, especially talking about remembrance during the 10 days. But we have a phone call from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. We have the sister on the phone. Peace and blessings be upon you. Please go ahead. His Eminence is listening to you. I was talking about my father. He wanted to perform a sacrifice. Thank you. We have Umbuthaina from Saudi Arabia. Peace and blessings be upon you. Your Eminence, talking about buying sacrifices. My father would like to buy sacrifices, but he postponed the payment of those sacrifices. You're talking about the price? It's postponed price, postponed payment. Thank you. I have a second question. My brother-in-law bought some livestock, and he promised the one who bought it from to pay those in later date. Can he be able to sacrifice from this livestock? What is the judgment pertaining putting the eye shadow and the makeup? The question of Imrinad, tomorrow's is the first day of Imsak. We mentioned that all of the judgments pertaining the 10 days start from the sunset of that day. And we're talking about holding all these actions. The best action is the remembrance of Allah Almighty. Staying, sitting, and exalting him, praising him, and reciting the Quran, and pursuing to conduct prayers on its on time. All of those are considered the good deeds. One of the other actions that you can get closer to Allah Almighty, fasting the day of Arafah. Because like Prophet Muhammad said, it wipes all the sins of the year prior and the coming year. All the sins during those 2 years, the best action is the pilgrimage. The best actions during Hajj or pilgrimage during the 9th and the 10th day of the Hijjah, which are considered within the 10 days of Tul Hijjah, and those are the most loved days to Allah Almighty. The best action to Allah, just to get closer to Allah by sacrificing animals and gifting. And for example, concerning the Makkah's people, and just to get closer to Allah by sacrificing the animals or the. It's the best days because they are better than other days, as came in the hadith of Prophet Muhammad. There are no better actions greater than those actions, better than the ones during those days, as Bukhari have narrated. the best day has a certain virtue, a special virtue, and sacrificing in the 10th day, it's to take advantage and an initiative to get closer and to shed blood of this sacrifice during those holy days. We're pertaining or concerning this sacrificed animal, talking about the 11th and the 12th and the 13th day. Those are the best days. But the best out of all days is during the day of sacrifice. But coming back to the sister's question, as Umm Salama narrated that Prophet Muhammad said, if the 10th day came and if someone would like to sacrifice, he would not touch his skin or his hair with anything. And he would not cut his nail until he performed sacrifice. And that indicates that those who want to perform sacrifices, those who want to intend within heart, and they exert the money, and they assign the money to pay for it, and they have to withhold prevent cutting their hair, or removing hair, or removing nail, or even removing any thing on the skin, and he should not trim or cut his nails. And that's what came from Prophet Muhammad's words. And this starts from the sunset of the entering of the first night of those 10 days, which is today's night or this night. The stop cutting and all that stuff. There's a lot of details. What is the judgment pertaining stopping or preventing from cutting? What are the penalty? We have another question. We have a call from Saudi Arabia. I'm sorry for the delay, but go ahead. You can start your question. Your Eminence, I would like to ask the best actions to get closer to Allah Almighty. We just spoke a little bit. Weren't you watching? Thank you so much. We have Sister Ghufran from Saudi Arabia. Peace and blessings be upon you. I have a question to His Eminence. We have sisters from Mecca that they want to perform a pilgrimage. Do they have to have a muhram with them? Do we have time for answers? Yes, we do. Concerning, you can go ahead, Your Eminence. The judgment concerning to start from preventing oneself from cutting by the time of entering the first night of the first 10 days, and then he can be able to prepare himself to sacrifice. There's a lot of judgments that concerns a lot of people. And now preventing from cutting skin or hair, it is performing the orders of Prophet Muhammad. And now we are submit ourselves to what Allah Almighty had ordered us to do. And concerning the judgment, prohibiting cutting, the scholars had three opinions. Some of them, they said that cutting skin, hair, and the nails are prohibited completely. It's one of the Ibn Ahmad and some of the scholars also, they took by this opinion because they should not touch the skin, the hair, and the nail because it has a prohibition. And this the second opinion said it's disliked. And whoever said this, they said it because some of them said it's a weak hadith, but it is a confirmed hadith. And some of them, it was narrated by Prophet Muhammad that he said his sacrificed livestock, and that's why if it's not prohibited to send the livestock in the matter of prohibition, they made this, that it is indicating that it's not for the purpose of prohibition, but it's for the disliking matter. That's why Ibn Malik took by this opinion, Ibn Malik and his companions. It's not disliked or prohibiting based on Aisha's hadith that Prophet Muhammad, he sent his livestock to Mecca, and he was not prohibiting, it was not prohibited, and it was totally allowed and lawful for his for the Prophet Muhammad. And most of the group, they said that we should not take by this because it is liked. Thank you so much. After the break, we'll come back.
Our viewers, you are welcome back in the second part of rituals from the sponsored by the Ministry of Islamic Affairs and Guidance. And this we talk with Professor Dr. Khalid bin Abdullah al-Muslah about the attributes of the first 10 of Dhul Hijjah. With the consensus scholars say, some people say, make this issue may prevent him from sacrificing, and some of them to have an exit out of it, or to ask my sister or the sister of this, it is related to the owner of the sacrificed animal, and to deputize it, to give it to a charity. The ruling is related on which the Prophet says, do not take any of your hair or nails. This is related to deputization. If someone if there is violation, what is the judgment about the sacrifice? It is valid, and we should start with it. It is loved by God. It is one of its rituals, and they are. This should not prevent you from a branch ruling to refrain from it, or in order to enjoy to take from your hair and your nails. With regard to an issue, when will it end? Until they are released from ihram. And those who the rulings is built on the likely thinking that they have performed what you have been deputized to do. And this is removed, and at the time when the sacrifice is slaughtered. These are of the questions related to the Eid sacrifice. And it is enough for the man and his family members. And the Prophet, blessings and peace upon him, that he sacrificed a sheep and for him and his family, and the general jurist say that the sunnah is realized by slaughtering one sacrifice. There is no need that every member of the family sacrifice. The head of the family may sacrifice for the whole family members. And even if they are 100 people or 1,000, as long as they are in one family or in one house or a compound, and they have one family and it is enough. One sacrifice is enough for them all. Many ask about deputization in sending the sacrificed animals to the countries which need such sacrifices. Does it realize the sunnah of the sacrifice or not? Fawaz from Saudi Arabia, peace be upon you. Yes, what is your question? I performed Umrah first. Hajj. Misan from Saudi Arabia, peace be upon you. I hope God will accept from me and you. And Ben Uthameen, may God bless him, that the person should take from the sacrificed animal. Here, now, you take the coupon, but you don't take from the sacrificed animal anything. Ben Uthameen said that he should eat from the sacrificed animal. How can he take from it? And are such coupons are valid or not? And he has real desire to sacrifice. But is your question is clear? Thank you. We have Abu Umar from Kuwait. Umar. Peace be upon you. Thank you. And I would like to ask the Sheikh, if the sacrificed animal is pregnant, then gave birth. If he does not mention the name of Allah when he slaughters the sacrificed animal, is it valid or not? The third question, on the day of Arafah, it is released from fire. Is it for the people standing at Arafah or the people in general? Shall we complete or take other questions? And we stopped at the question of our sister to send the sacrificed animal to those who want to sacrifice in the countries which are needy. It is under his hand, and he witnessed it and slaughter it by himself and eat it. This is the ritual performed by the Prophet, blessings and peace upon him. And he got to rams and he slaughtered them by his hand. And God says, eat from it and feed the poor. The valid thing to be under his hand and to be nearer to God by eating from it. And the general scholars, it is desired to eat from it in compliance of the saying of God Almighty, that eating from the sacrificed animal is obligatory. And to deputize another one, he has the right to ask a part of the sacrificed animal, but he has... the eating from the sacrificed animal, it is desired and liked, but it is not obligatory. It is how can he eat? God says, eat from it and feed the needy and the poor. All that the recommended thing is to give from these sacrificed animal, and those the problem raised by Maisa is related if the man finds it is obligatory to eat from it. In origin, to send the sacrifices abroad, I don't accept it unless there is bad need or realized interest in sending them, which are above the interest of or the it is not intended for eating, and we can't send money. It is not intended to be eaten or to make the people feel their desire and not becoming hungry. This is one of the intentions behind it. But the other intentions is to approach and be near to God and to magnify what is magnified by Allah. And if he deputizes, he can't attend the sacrifice. It is the priority is to sacrifice for aid in his country. And if there is bad need in Sham, Syria, and other countries which in which there is starvation or people are in bad need, and it is very necessary, as in Ghouta or the Homs in Syria, or the other cities in which, or the countries in which it is sacrificed in them. And the when we make balance, if it is likely according to his discretion, it is to meet the need or the imperative need of such people. And I say it is to you may we combine between these two issues and to send and you slaughter for yourself in your country to yourself and to your family members. The second thing, there are sometimes there are sacrifices which are ordered or we will work in this meat. We can't deal with it properly, and they slaughter in a way which to get rid of them, not to look for what is more useful, just to get rid of them, not to put them in the right or proper place. The things which are required between the performance of the ritual and what is related to his country, and the excess of that can be sent to the needy people in other countries. This is related to the sacrifices we see and hear, that there is something which prevents in absolute, and others they encourage in absolute. And this saying is to make balance between the intentions and the interest, which is the middle between these two trends with regard to sending the sacrifices to other countries. We have many questions. Jinad from Saudi Arabia, she mentioned to abstain from cutting hair and nails. If she may pay the money later on, I hope that they can, but in origin, the sacrifice, it is confirmed sunnah for those who are able. It is a confirmed sunnah for the able, and we have general evidences, and they narrated by Imam Ahmad from the Prophet, he who does not sacrifice, and he is, has the ability to sacrifice and does not do it, he shouldn't come to our mosque. And the deferred payment for the sacrifice, this is what I mentioned before. Can the woman put cosmetics or eyeliner? It is not what is on to put on the lip, she should watch not to have something go inside her throat. Abdurrahman from Sudan, peace be upon you. Fath al-Rahman. Peace be upon you. Your question, please, specific. I have two questions for Sheikh. First, if I am coming from Sudan and I visit Medina, and the buses move from Medina to Diyar Ali, what is the question? Shall I put on the ihram garments from the hotel? And when I reach, or shall I reach Diyar Ali and start putting on these garments? I read the books about Hajj and those who perform Umrah, and to Sheikh bin Baaz, and I want to have these books are long and detailed books. And if there is a book which talks about farewell Hajj, Fatma from Algeria, he wants books, the more detailed books about Hajj and Umrah from Sudan. After the interval, we will answer the questions. We will come back to you later, and please remain. Welcome back, our viewers, in the third part, which is the last in our episode of program Rituals on Rituals, about the first 10 of days of the Hijjah and their virtues, the best acts to be to cause us to be near to God. Some people, a group of women from Mecca want to perform Hajj. Do they need somebody who is an unmarriageable man to accompany them? No, because they are living close to the Haram. He may perform Umrah and Hajj when he comes to Mecca, and he should the people of Haram. There is no they have to fast 3 and 7 when they go back. If they are not living in the sacred precinct, and there is those who are living there, they do not need to slaughter any sheep. Amal from Jordan, peace be upon you. How are you, Sheikh? Yes. I ask you about the days after Eid. Is it from on the day of Eid day or the other days? About refrain from touching the hair and nails or cutting them. There's a call. Is there a call? Peace be upon you. I'm Saleh from Saudi Arabia. Congratulations for the blessed days, the first 10 days of the Hijjah. A question. Shall he sacrifice or deputize somebody to cut his hair, or about deputization and coupons and to buy from? We will talk in details. Umar from Kuwait, if it is the sacrificed animal, it is pregnant and give birth, the born sheep is accompanied with a male sheep as it is a sacrifice. When it is slaughtered, if he forgets mentioning the name of God, the scholars have two sayings. They say it is unlawful, the sacrifice, do not eat from the sacrifice which is not, which the name of God is not mentioned on it. And this, there is no harm on him, and the sacrifice is lawful. This is acceptable. Hello, Sheikh. I wanted to ask you a question. I will perform Hajj. I will go to go to Egypt. Can I throw stones after dawn and go farewell circumambulation and leave? I will throw after dawn prayers because I have certain circumstances. And it is general for all this. This is, you know, to be free from fire, those who are at Arafat. It is general, or it is general. And those who should refrain from cutting his hair or nail. Abdel Ilaha, say, answered, I don't. There is a problem in his skin. If it is harmful, he may remove it, and there is no harm. And if there is a nail, when it is necessary and he is harmed from it, he may remove it. Sheikh Khalid. The, if the price of the sacrifice mentioned, when he says the price of my sacrifice is so and so, it is just boasting, and he wants to show off, and it is cheap or not, it is, you know, it is not acceptable. Abdurrahman is asking, there is no harm to have to put the ihram garments. It is a preparation, but the preparation is to have the intention in his heart, or to say labbaik allahumma umratan, or chanting labbaik for the there are many books on Hajj. The Prophet's pilgrimage and farewell pilgrimage. If he goes to any Islamic bookshop, he can write. And there is the hadith of Jabir. Many of the scholar talks, among them Bin Uthaymeen and Bin Baz, and Muhammad bin Uthaymeen in an explanation on the on this book. The, what is the proper form of takbir? God is the greatest. God is the greatest. There is no God but Allah, and praise be to Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and praise be to Allah. God is, and praise to Allah. And there is no, nothing fixed about the Prophet and the things related from his companion, and achieving any of these things will realize the goal. What is the ruling for my going to go for Hajj without Mahram? Mahram, the person who is unmarriageable for her. And to, she should accompany a Mahram. If she couldn't find, or he refuses, or postpones, and it is easy for her to go with a good company, and there is no harm in this. And she may realize what she desires for. And the question is the right about the days after Eid al-Adha. She is asking the days of Tashriq. It is the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th, and from today and to the sunset of the 13th day, there is to say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar after the prescribed prayers in a group, alone, in travel, in sitting, in standing, and after the prescribed prayers for non-pilgrims. And he said he asked God to forgive him or to have other invocations, and it continues until the last day of Eid, which is the absolute and the restricted one. It is after the prescribed prayer. And Muhammad from Saudi Arabia, he mentioned, can he throw after dawn? He means on that 12th day. There is no harm if he has certain circumstances, and in Ahmad school and the Hanafi school, there is no harm in this. What is the absolute and the restricted? The absolute at any time, from tonight until the sunset of the 13th day of the Hijjah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, there is no God but Allah. And every time he is standing, sitting in the car, in waiting, and where with people, at any time, it is not restricted to any time. This is the absolute. The restricted, it is associated with something. It is after the prescribed prayers and starts from the dawn of Arafah and ends in the mid-afternoon of for the pilgrim, from the noon of the slaughtering day to the afternoon of the last day of the 3 days after Eid. Who wants to sacrifice and he couldn't find a sacrificed animal, and he refrains from doing that. And he has what he has intended in its recompense. The father who will sacrifice man who refrains from cutting hair and nails is the man who slaughters, and he pays the money for it. And the family members are not concerned with this. What is the sin which nullifies Hajj? To be a renegade, to leave Islam and go to another creed or faith. But spoiling it is the to have sexual intercourse with his wife, that spoils it. But the corruption is of this is through the sexual intercourse. We have answered a lot of questions. Thank you very much. I hope with our viewers, we have spent with you this program, which is within the effort of the Ministry of Islamic Affairs, Da'wah and Irshad, headed by the Minister Saleh bin al-Sheikh and Talal bin Bakhit, and the godfather of this program and several programs, and the producer and manager of this program. And in the coming period, we will provide you with several programs, and you will, until then, peace be upon you all. Thank you.